God's Son is here to preach to you about Jesus Christ. Hoping that some of you will give your life to Jesus Christ today. Amen. In John 14, verse 1, Jesus Christ said, "Let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and also believe in me." Who says this is the maker of heavens and earth. He's saying to you today through me, I'm just a Western, you know, but he said the message. Jesus Christ said to you, "Let not your heart be troubled." Amen. If you need love, Jesus Christ is the love that you need. If you need peace, Jesus is the peace that you need. In Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, say that Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace. In John 3:16, the Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son." Now, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. So Jesus Christ is telling you today, let not your heart be troubled. When you are troubled, Jesus Christ is troubled also. When you are in affliction, Jesus Christ is so afflicted. Jesus Christ said, Matthew 11, verse 28, "Come to me, all who are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Are you tired with the society? Are you tired with the issues in life? Jesus Christ said, "Come to me and I will give you rest." Amen. He said, "Come to me, all those who are heavy laden, and you will find rest for your soul." Yes. He said, "Take my yoke. My yoke is easy and my burden is light." God bless you, sir. So whatever thing you are going through right now, Jesus Christ knows. There's nothing that happened to God that will say, "Oops, I didn't know about it." God knows everything, my dear friend. If you are stressed out, God also is stressed out. If you are tired, God also is tired. If you are weak, God also is weak. And he said, "Come to me and give me those your tiredness and your weakness, and he will make you to be strong." Apostle Paul complained 3 times in the Bible. And Jesus Christ said to him, "My grace is sufficient enough for you." That grace of God in Jesus Christ is here today. He wants to comfort those who are weak. He wants to give strength to those who are weak. He wants to uplift those who are down. That's who Jesus Christ is. He's a merciful God. And he's talking to you today. And he said to you, "Son, do not let your heart be troubled." He said, "In my father's house, there is many mansions. If it were not so, who would have told you so?" He said that, "I go ahead of you, and where I am, you may also be." Don't you want to be with God? Of course you want, my dear friend. The opposite of not being with God is a place of torment. It's a place of anguish. It's a place of pain. It's a place where the worms never die. It's a place where the final perishes. So my dear friend, don't go there. Just give your life to Jesus Christ. He said, "Let not your heart be troubled." What is troubling you today? Is that family issues? Is that marriage issues? Is that your husband? Is that your wife? Is that your sugar? God loves you. He knows what you are going through. And the reason why we are here is to tell that God loves you, because he can answer that your problem. Is his answer to your solutions of that problem that you are having through right now. Many of you right now are down and out. You don't know where to go. You are stressed out. You are in pain. Maybe NHS could not cure you. But I want to tell you today that the word of God will cure you, and that word of God is Jesus Christ. Are you stressed out in life to the point whereby you go for the bottle? I want to tell you that bottle is empty. You need Jesus Christ. The Bible says, "Not fear yourself with wine, but fill yourself with the Holy Spirit." If you are empty, Holy Spirit will fill you up. The reason why you are stressed out is because you have not found Jesus Christ. When you find Jesus Christ, your problem is solved. That's why he gives you the inner peace. In this world, you can never have peace, Jesus Christ says. He said, "But take heart, because I overcome the world." And he gives you the peace that passes every understanding and every misunderstanding too. Young people, do you know Jesus? Tell me. Tell me what you know about Jesus. You see? And that's the point. Do you know Jesus, brother? Do you know Jesus? He loves you, brother. Have you given your life to Jesus?
believe he's a prophet.
Sorry, you believe he's a prophet? What do you know about him?
You say so Christ that a man a prophet by God.
By God, let me ask you a question. Can God make that man to come back to life? Can God make that man to come back to life? Can God make that man to come back to life?
Thanks God.
That's my question to you. Can God make that man to come back to life?
Yes or no?
Yes or no? Sorry? With God, all things are possible, brother. God can make a dead man to come back to life. Talk to him.
You
don't call somebody a liar without you having any evidence. Talk to him, please. You see, that's the problem. Simple question. Can God make the man to come back to life? Moses cannot answer because if they say yes,
what God cannot do does not exist. He's never been created.
So we are talking about Jesus today. He knows what you are going through. He knows what you are going through. He's the only one who can set you free. He's the only one who can save you. You cannot save yourself, my dear friend.
What I know about
you, you try, but you fail.
I know Jesus.
Only Jesus can save us. Why? Because Jesus is God. That's why we are waiting to give life to Jesus right now. Jesus. Do you know Jesus?
Yeah.
Are you saved?
Fine.
Are you born again?
Am I?
Are you born again?
I believe so.
You don't believe so, you should know so.
Yeah.
What makes you to be born again?
Jesus loves everyone.
Yes, but what makes you to be born again?
The whole world can hear my thoughts.
Sir, Jesus Christ said to the Nicodemus in John chapter 3, verse 3,
can hear my thoughts.
You must
hear my brain.
Sorry?
Everybody can hear my brain.
I don't hear your brain. Only God knows your brain, sir. So do you want to give your life to Jesus? Because this world has come down to. Do you want to give your life to Jesus? What's your name, sir?
Bobby.
Bobby? My name is Kinsley. All you have to invite him into your heart right now. Are you willing to do that?
Say again.
Are you willing to invite Jesus into your heart?
Yes, of course. Oh, yeah.
Okay, repeat that after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Come into my heart.
Come into my house.
Heart.
Heart.
Be my Lord.
Be my Lord.
And my Savior.
My Savior.
I believe.
I believe.
You died for my sins.
You died for my sins.
And you rose again.
You rose again.
You are in heaven.
You're in heaven.
When I die.
When I die.
I will be with you.
I will be with you. Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Come one more thing before you go, Bobby. Repeat after me. Say, dear Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Come into my life.
Come into my life.
To be my Lord.
To be my Lord.
And my Savior.
My Savior.
Lead me. Lead me.
Lead.
Lead me.
Lead me.
Yeah. To live for you.
To live for you.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, brother.
How are you doing? You have a contact number. God bless you.
I wouldn't mind.
You can give me your number. I want to call you so I can keep in touch with you.
But do you have a church? Do you go
I have
to
a church.
Whereabouts is the church?
Where do you live?
I live far from
okay, I live in
Southport. Southport.
I'm a Southport.
Yeah.
I will get your church there. Give me your contact, okay?
Okay. No, but would it be a lot to go from Southport to?
I will direct you a church where you live. I will get you a church where you live.
975.
Don't say it. Glory, hallelujah. My brother, even in the heavens.
75. 34. Wait a second, please.
That's right.
Sing up. Peace.
Well, let him give you a number you call him.
Okay, it's 07534.
Okay, what's your name? Yes, it's Lord, my sister. God bless you, Jesus loves you.
907-299.
I will call you tomorrow.
Yeah, no problem.
God bless you, Bobby.
Okay. okay then.
God loves you, baby.
What about direction?
I will do that. I'll make my
response. Jesus Christ.
I will test you, yes.
All
right. God bless you, sir.
Can we keep in touch, me and you? I give my number.
I have his number. I'll give it to you.
Is that it? All right, no worries.
Yeah. God bless you, my brother.
Anytime you want someone chat to call me, bro.
Call me. God bless you.
My name is Roy. Yeah, it's Roy.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
So, my dear friends, the only way for salvation is Jesus Christ. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you are living in darkness. And the Bible says that darkness represents sin. If a man is not walking the light, he's walking dark. And many people today are walking dark because they don't know the light. The Bible says in John chapter 1, verse 9, the true light that shines to every man coming to the world is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the true light that shines in darkness. Please don't fight. Please, I beg you, don't fight, please.
Please,
and if a man have no Jesus, he have no peace in you. That's right. The Bible said to wise in the book of Isaiah, there's no peace for the wicked. If you reject the Prince of Peace, you can never have peace in this life. You cannot find peace in drink. You cannot find peace in anything. Only the peace you have is in Jesus Christ. Amen. So God is calling you today. The only way you can have peace in this life is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior. And only Jesus Christ can give you that peace. I don't know what you're looking for tonight, but I tell you there's a reason why God sent you out here tonight, that we are here preaching to you. If you are willing to open your heart, you can accept Jesus Christ today as your Lord and personal Savior. The Bible says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him up from death, you shall be saved. Amen. Salvation is a free gift. You cannot be saved by your good works. You cannot be saved by your good works. You cannot be saved by your good looks. You cannot be saved by your good earning. You can only be saved by the grace of God. That's right. Your good works is good as dead. It's a filthy rag in the eyes of God. What you do with the filthy rag, you put them in the bin. That's why all your self-righteousness cannot save you. If you are saved by your self-righteousness, let me ask you a question. Why did Jesus Christ die on the cross? Why did he die on the cross? You see? He died on the cross because of our sins. We crucify him. Don't get the idea the Roman soldiers crucify him. All of us crucify Jesus Christ. The Bible says we are slain before the beginning of the foundation of the world. He was slain before the world was created. Jesus Christ died for our sins. You know Jesus, brother? You see? Do you know Jesus? Do any of you know Jesus Christ? Can any of you come here and tell me what you know about Jesus? It's an open question time. Do you know Jesus, young people? Tell me what you know about him. One thing. Just one thing.
Resurrected.
Amen.
Resurrected.
What about you? Do you know Jesus?
Jesus loves you.
Jesus
loves you.
Don't be shy.
Jesus loves Jesus. Spanish.
So, Spanish. Scenario. God bless you. So, we are talking today about the Prince of Peace himself, Jesus Christ. There's only way for us to have peace with God. Jesus Christ became the peace treaty between man and God. Jesus Christ reconciled us back to God. How? By dying for us on the cross. He died a painful death in agony. He was naked. He was pierced. The Bible said the chastisement and all this thing was laid upon him. Upon one person, Jesus Christ. Why? Because he loved us so much. The Bible said this is not that the God manifested himself. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen. This time I'll try to come with you and Bibles. So we are talking today, you know Jesus?
No.
Yes.
Father, are you saved? Father, doing that will save you. You have to be in the heart. You have to be in the heart. God bless
you. In your heart.
What about you, you know Jesus?
Yes, I know. I respect him, but I'm not a Christian.
You respect him?
Yes, I'm not. I'm Muslim.
You're a Muslim?
Yes.
What made you to be a Muslim?
I can't talk about this, but I'm Muslim, and this is my heart. That's
what,
all.
What makes you to be a Muslim?
What makes you to be a Muslim? What do you mean?
What makes you to be a Muslim? It's a very simple question, sir.
When I was a child, I was Muslim.
That's the problem. You see, when now you are not child anymore, you have grown.
I know, but
you have to make... Brother, you have to make your own decision.
Okay, this is my choice.
Sorry?
This is my choice.
I respect the choice.
That's it.
But when you die, when you die, when you die, when you die, you find out Jesus is Lord. Then it is too late. And too sad. And too bad.
That is what you know.
So friends,
what you don't know, Jesus, remember the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And everybody has different.
That's off it, because your finger is there. Come put your finger there.
You know, Jesus is our religion. Your faith is called Isa.
We don't believe that Isa.
You don't believe it?
No, it's not Jesus.
You believe that?
That name Isa cannot be proven. It's just a makeup name.
Okay. Also, we don't believe that Jesus is God. He's a messenger in our religion. That's
sorry?
In our religion, Jesus is
God. But I want to invite you to Christ. I'm not inviting to religion. Religion tells you to dress like this, walk like this, put beer at this religion. That's my name. I'm inviting you to relationship, fellowship, and friendship. This is beyond religion. Let me ask you a question. Do you pray?